ain't to be had at all. The streets are full of guys pushing each other.
Mexico? Why, sure there is. Not 10 days from here, Berreo and pack train is a mountain waiting for the right guy to come along, discover a treasure, and then tickle it, which lets him have it. Question is, are the right guy? real bonanzas are few and far between. They take a lot of finding. Say, answer me this, will you? Why is gold worth some $20 an ounce?
I don't know. Because it's scarce.
1,000 men say go searching for gold. After 6 months, one of them's lucky. 1 out of 1,000. His find represents not only his own labor, but that of 999 others to boot. That's 6,000 months or 500 years, scrabbling over mountains, going hungry and thirsty. Now, it's the gold, mister, is worth what it is because of the human labor that went into the finding and the getting of it.
Never thought of it just like that.
Well, there's no other explanation, mister. Gold and stuff ain't good for nothing except for making jewelry with gold teeth. gold's a devilish sort of a thing anyway. You start out, you tell yourself you'd be satisfied with 25,000 handsome smaggots worth of it. Say, help my lord and cross my heart. Fine resolution. After months of sweating yourself dizzy and growing short on provisions and finding nothing, you finally come down to 15,000, then 10. Finally, you say, Lord, let me just find $5,000 worth and never ask for anything more the rest of my life.
$5,000 is a lot of money.
Mm. Yeah, hearing this joint seems like a lot, but I tell you, if it was to make a real strike, you couldn't be dragged away. Not even the threat of miserable death would keep you from trying to add 10,000 more. 10, you'd want to get 25. 25, you want to get 50. 50, 100, like roulette. One more turn, you know, always one more.
It wouldn't be that way with me. I swear it wouldn't. I take only what I set out to get. Even if there's still $500,000 worth lying around waiting to be picked up.
I've dug in Alaska and Canada and Colorado. I was with the crowd in the British Honduras where it made my fare back home and almost enough over to cure me of the fever I'd caught. Dug in California and Australia, all over the world practically. Yeah, I know what gold does to men's souls.
You talk as though you struck it rich sometime or other, Pop. How about it? And what are you doing in here, the down and outer?
That's the gold. That's what it makes us. Never knew a prospector yet that died rich. Make one fortune, sure to blow it in trying to find another. I'm no exception to the rule. sure, I'm an odd old bone now, but say, don't you guys think the spirit's gone? I'm all set to shoulder a pickaxe and a shovel anytime anybody's willing to share expenses. I'd rather go by myself. Going it alone is the best way. But you got to have a stomach for loneliness. Some guys go nutty with it. On the other hand, going with a partner, too, is dangerous. Murder's always lurking about. Partners accusing each other of all sorts of crimes. as long as there's no find, the noble brotherhood will last. But when the piles of gold begin to grow, that's when the trouble starts.
Me, now, I wouldn't mind a little of that kind of trouble.
I think I'll go to sleep and dream about piles of gold getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
I'm thinking we ought to give up. Leave the whole outfit. Everything behind and go back to civilization.
What's that you say? Go back? Well, tell my old grandmother. I got two very elegant bedfellows who kick at the first drop of rain and hide in the closet from thunder rumbles. My, what great prospectors. Two shoe clerks reading the magazine about prospecting for gold in the land of the midnight sun, south of the border or west of the Rockies.
Shut your trap. Shut up, Ross. Smash your head flat.
Go ahead. Throw it. If you did, you'd never leave this wilderness alive. Without me, you two would die here more miserable than rats.
I'll leave him alone.
Can't you see the old man's nuts?
Nuts! Nuts, am I? Let me tell you something, my two fine bedfellows. You're so dumb, there's nothing to compare you with. You're dumber than the dumbest jackass. Look at each other, will you? Do you ever see anything like yourself for being dumb specimens? You're so dumb, you don't even see the riches you're treading on with your own feet.